Hello everyone, welcome back for more Let's Play Battletech. Joining me is JKLantern.
Who is still eating jelly babies.
But are they boomers?
I know,
that's
right?
A good question now. And most of you will never get the logic that led to that question.
Nope.
And you never will. Anyway, so let's see. Field is clear to begin proper operation. So we need to go get a guy, which means we need to stand a unit on top of him until we pick him up. That is a valid question. Okay, Devinder, you're not totally horrid.
Again, of the liaisons, he's the one who's, like, the nice guy. Like, all of the other ones are deplorable, with the exception of Bob Carita, who is amazing.
Which we haven't seen any of his flashpoints that aren't DLC yet.
I think you have to have higher points with Carita to do that,
probably.
But...
Which means I'd probably have to drop an alliance or two just to be able to do it.
Oh no, you have to drop the alliance with you do have to drop the alliance with Davian to do that, and they have awesome autocannons.
Yep.
Shit.
Yep. Well, after a year, I can try to re-get the alliance with Davian if I break it.
Mm-hmm.
It just makes you wait a in-game year.
Yeah.
So, let's see. Flashpoint decision. Major research base, won't have that place locked up tight with assault mechs. If you take light mechs into that, we'll be grounded to scrap metal, more than likely. Thank God.
Subtlety is not our strong point.
No, we are not subtle. Of course, this means we'll probably have several assault mechs to deal with, but...
Promote that man.
I think I'm equipped to deal with assault mechs. I think I'm very well equipped to deal with assault mechs.
Yep.
So before we do... I need to get a med bay.
We should probably repair those medium mechs that got damaged.
Probably. I don't think it'll take too long. I don't think we lost any components.
Yeah.
Yeah, if it's just letting me hit repair... I lost no components. There we go.
That work order you submitted is complete.
There we go. Okay. Marik Alliance Mark III. You know, I'm gonna let Yang handle that.
Yang Circus, Yang's Monkey.
Yep. So, not a lot of money involved in this mission. So I might as well go for higher salvage, since I'm not getting much money out of it. Mm-hmm.
I love that name because it makes you have to think about it. The Genesis.
Yep. Where the hell is...
second
want
row.
To drop, do we want to drop McMurdo or do we want something bigger? Yeah, we'll probably drop McMurdo. Since it's good at capping heads.
If we can ever find a place that has a hatchet that we can mount on the awesome, that'll be hilarious.
Yeah, it kind of will, won't it? There are leg actuators, too. You don't have to just stick the arms, you know. So the awesome could literally be just, it's three PPCs until you get up close and it literally punches you to death.
There's actually, so, a little bit later in the setting, like around 3050, House Steiner and House Davian essentially try to make a bigger brother to the Hatchet Man, and they make a 65-ton thing called the Axeman. The stock Axeman has a hatchet, a large pulse laser, a couple of medium lasers, and an AC-20. But, Dr. Banzai decides to come up with an experimental one, and I don't know how well this one works in the tabletop, but I like the idea. It takes off the AC-20 and replaces that with two LRM-15s. So you've basically got a missile boat with a great thing for discouraging anybody from coming anywhere near it.
Command interface initiated.
So we can pick up the data separately from the operative. So, let's see. Because after we pick everything up... That's why I like the Annihilator. Ballistic weapons get an extra 20% damage.
The DACAs become DACA-ier.
Yep. Also, the thing I put in there that makes heat generation drop by 20%.
Always useful on anything.
So, let's see. We need to approach, but not actually step in the thing.
Enemy detected.
You are a 65-ton mech sitting over there. Okay.
Not for long, it isn't.
Unfortunately, I don't have much... I don't have good amounts of cover...
Roger
to
that.
Go duck behind anything.
Well, that's a threatening mech.
Oh, yeah, total threat there. Okay, let's see.
What can I do for you?
I still don't have a really good... I don't have cover. That's the only problem.
You betcha.
Only problem is it's going to have evasion, which is going to make it a little harder to hit.
Standing by.
The question is, nope, you cannot get to any... You cannot get to deal with either of those 65-ton mechs over there. I'm going to save the resolve and just try to whittle down the cicada.
Negative damage, repeat, negative damage.
But so much evasion is going to be annoying.
Yeah. I will earn a potato, damn it.
Took a heavy hit there.
So one of those 65-ton mechs is a trebuchet, I'm guessing. Could be a
trebuchet
catapult.
Yeah, catapult would be the one.
Yeah.
Weirdly fond of the catapult.
Evade that.
Commander.
I love how you've just adopted the Annihilator as kind of your signature inner sphere mech.
Well, I mean, it works.
Yeah.
Really freaking well.
Target neutralized.
Unrelated to anything, if you ever do a Bravely Default LP, Star would like to join in on that.
Well, I thought if we talked about it, it was going to be all three of us at least.
Yeah, yeah. I thought we had that conversation at some point.
Yeah, good yeah, we did. I was going to say, wait a minute, we talked about that, and that was definitely a thing we were considering.
Yeah.
Affirmative. Locked on.
Jaeger mech, okay.
Okay.
One of them is a Jaeger mech, the other is probably the catapult.
Need something, Chief?
If I had to pick a signature Davian mech for myself, which, why would I do that?
Potato!
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 Potato! I would probably take the Jaeger mech. Not because it's good, but because it amuses me.
Okay, the other one was a Thunderbolt over there.
Oh, really?
Well, they have... Okay, this other 65 was a Thunderbolt. So there's a 60 over there with them. I just love the fact that we consider capping a head to be potato.
Potato.
Here comes the other lands.
Yes, Commander.
Roger. Well, time to fight in the shade.
Taking the shot.
As much as I'm
in cover, so.
As much as I'm not the missile boat guy, there is something immensely satisfying about watching a shitload of missiles fly from the heavens into a target.
I was really trying to get that to be four LRM-20s. I just could not make it work, though.
I mean, how Steiner couldn't make three LRM-20s work until they got recovered tech.
Okay, I'm gonna have to be careful here because they are coming in from the other side.
Firing on target.
Granted, I think I got the biggest damage dealer on the other side, on the first side over there, off the table.
Yeah.
Commander?
Getting the Jaeger mech off the table was probably the best thing at the moment.
Like, the Thunderbolt has a decent punch, but none of its... Like,
Rifleman.
None of its weapons individually are, like, a real hole puncher.
Unfortunately, we don't have a clean shot on the head at all, so...
Affirmative. Solid connection on that one.
Yeah, if we're not facing the front or the back, we can't really attack anything super vital, so we've just got to go with an arm and hope we blow off the torso with it.
Yeah.
Ready for orders.
I don't really have anywhere good to park you right now.
Let's see how you like this.
I don't think I need to target anything specific.
It's a rifleman. It's made of tissue paper.
Enemy mech destroyed. Warning. Armor low.
Yeah. Armor low on an Exorable still means you probably got about a foot thick plate to go.
Waiting for order. On my way. Here we go.
God, thunderbolts are annoying to take down.
Critical hit, Commander.
The dragon, okay.
Yes, Commander. Affirmative.
The good thing about where we are, no heat buildup.
Yeah.
Potato.
Potato.
Potato!
Potato!
Tango down.
Damage minimal.
God, that is such a nice mech for these missions. Mm. It really is. I mean, there's something about being able to just deal out a ton of damage. But there's just something so nice about getting a 2x bonus to critical shots.
Yeah, that's very nice. I know there's a piece of equipment in the tabletop game that allows you to have bonuses to call shots, the targeting computer. And in certain mechs, those mechs are ridiculously expensive battle value-wise.
What's up, Bach?
But those things, at least in the era they were introduced, were absolutely broken. Like the Black Python, the Vapor Eagle. I can't remember if the Rifleman 2C has a targeting computer or not. I'd have to look that up. But
Banshee or Cyclops?
I'd say the Banshee's the bigger threat, especially because it's 3S. AKA the not crab she.
It is going to take a while to chew through a banshee, though.
Yep.
I'm taking heavy hits, Commander.
Hey there. Copy that.
Potato!
Potato!
Aww.
Aww, no. Well, at least I hurt that guy.
You did.
Commander?
Still not as satisfying.
It, but it was not a potato.
It was not a potato.
Right, Commander.
left side has just been taking a beating from this. So I'm going to kind of turn my, see if I can turn my left side away from that a little bit.
Good lord. The Cyclops is known for having, like, a very visible and fragile head. Why is its head still there?
Because I didn't I couldn't specifically target it, other than the once.
Yes, Commander.
Yeah, canonically, like, people tried to build, like, hats for their Cyclopses to try to make them more survivable. I think it was the New Avalon Institute of Science actually did a study of this and found that, like, that actually makes things much worse. The shrapnel tends to get into things that you don't want to get into. Also, it screws up your ability to eject.
Yeah.
I can't take much more of this.
That Banshee is going to have to go a turn or two without firing much, I think, because it's just about to cook.
Ready for orders.
Clearly I need to stick a potato on it. So I can have dinner.
Potato?
Potato.
Potato!
Potato! Ooh, lethal damage.
Well, it's blowing up the head.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't get around that not being lethal damage most times.
Potato.
Firing everything I've got.
There are still enemies out there, but we have definitely dealt with the, oh, that's a 95 version, 95 tons.
So another Banshee? Pretty much has to be, that's the only 95 ton mech in this game, I'm pretty sure.
In the Highlander 95?
Highlander's 90.
No. Oh.
Unless I'm misremembering.
Go.
Yeah, 95's an odd weight bracket. I don't think there are that many Canon 95 ton mechs. In fact, I'm tempted. Let's see here.
It is another Banshee and it's a 3M.
Oh, okay.
Question is, do you earn another potato?
I come.
Yeah,
nope.
In canon, of like all the mech designs out there, there are 21 95 ton mechs, so yeah, it's not a lot.
That's still quite a few.
Keep in mind, that's like from 3025 to like 3150 in terms
armor,
of technical
buddy.
Readouts. It's a, like, of hundreds of mechs. Like, I don't know how many total mech designs there are in canon, but like of hundreds of mechs, there are 21.
That took its head off. Okay, well.
Time to go rescue some dudes.
Yep.
Moving to position.
Roger that.
Heading out. Coordinates received.
Heading out.
The secondary asset has been secured.
Okay, now the Annihilator just can't get blown up.
On the move. Moving to position.
Roger.
And now, if I haven't read this wrong, once we get over to the other site, unless they decide to spring another lance on us. There we go. When a mission gives you 5 potatoes, it becomes an easy mission.
Yes.
I really wish we'd thought of that joke much earlier, but hey.
Yes, like, I wish we came up with that, like, at the start of the LP.
No internal damage on anybody. Okay, let's see, what do I want to take home? I mean, technically one Banshee is good another, but I could build... The way this it's laid out.
Two entire Banshees.
Yep. And a good laser.
One really awesome medium laser.
There are some other good things out there. That gyro was nice. Rangefinder is good. The TTS is good.